Okay, this is the water quality portal, and this is the most important part here is the download data page. So the data page allows for a variety of different query options. You can query by location, for example, states. Search for Wisconsin, you can search for multiple states, you can search for counties within those states. You can also search using geospatial locations. For example, you can use a location. This one is using a geolocated from my browser. If you were on a phone, you could also use that. I could search within 50 miles of my location or 100 miles. And you can search by site type and parameter. So, for example, search for wells. Zoom in a little bit. So you can search for wells or streams. You can choose organization IDs. So, for example, if you were looking for Wisconsin, DNR, you could get that information. You can also get, and you can choose multiple organizations if you want. You can search by site ID if you know exactly what that site ID is. You can search for the hydrologic unit code if you're interested in a specific hydrologic unit code, and you can actually use wildcards. So, for example, if you were looking for the Upper Mississippi, you could search for just the 04, the HUC 4, and get that information. So you can search for up to HUC 8s here in the HUC search. You can also search for, say, if you're looking for water samples, you can choose different sample media: water, air, biological, sediment, etc. You can choose by characteristic group. So, for example, inorganics or nutrients, or pesticides, physical, all those types of basic information you can get from characteristic group. Or if you're looking for a very specific characteristic, you can search for that too. Just pull in from a much larger list all the different characteristics that are available in the portal. You can get all the different nitrate characteristics. You can see here that there's actually one of the questions or challenges that we have as the portal. As an aggregator of data, there are many different ways to write even just nitrate for collecting data, and this is a challenge that we are just starting to work on as we're tackling getting the data available. How best to answer the question of, there are 17 different ways that you can write just nitrate. What does that mean for my data? So you can also choose parameter codes if you're familiar with NWIS parameter codes, and you can choose and you can also filter by date ranges. If you're only interested in a specific database, you can also choose that. Once you've narrowed your choices, you can get a, you can choose to either download the data, but maybe you want to see where that data is. So show sites on map, and you can see that what you're going to see here gives a quick preview, how many sites you're going to resolve, and then you can continue here. You can get the data on a map. See, another challenge of aggregated data sets, there are a few data sets that aren't that have probably extraneous pieces of information. I rather doubt any Wisconsin organization is actually collecting data down in the Galapagos. But you can zoom in on an area of interest. Maybe you're particularly interested in this area of the Nicolet National Forest, you can actually choose an area of interest and get back a set of sites that are interesting with your basic site information. And you can actually then download that information for this given bounding box directly from this site information pop-up. To go over a little bit more of the download information, you can download either site information or sample result information. And site information has all the different metadata about the site, where the site is located, what type of site it is, who the responsible organization is for that site, some basic well information. There's a little bit more well information coming out of NWIS than from STORET, and other information such as like that. Sample results are the actual sample result information for each site, and the site ID is the key piece that allows you to join those two tables or result sets together. And you can download your data either as a common separated tab separated in Excel, or for site information, you can also download that information as KML. So just a quick demonstration on the site information. See that, and you can download that information. And there's your site information. Similarly, if you wanted to download the sample information for all of Wisconsin streams, I'm actually not going to download this because we've got a 9 million row table that we'd be pulling from, but you can get a basic information as to what's going on here. There is extensive documentation as to what these fields are in the user guide for the portal. It also gives basic information about how to use the portal as well. Different parameters, definitions of all the different parameters. And here you can get all the different headers for those CSVs or Excel documents and what they mean. And these are pulled from the from WQX and ultimately from the WQX outbound schema, which is a superset, an extension of the WQX schema that's used to submit data to the portal, to STORET via the data exchange. So let's go back from the user guide back to the portal itself. Another important thing to see is down here is the REST-like queries. So what does REST-like queries mean? REST-like queries means that for a given search, so if we were interested in Wisconsin, and this time we only wanted it in Dane County, and we wanted streams and wells, and we wanted nutrients. We've built a somewhat complex query. You can show REST-like queries, and we've got the entire set information is right here. So what this means is this is a URL that you can actually paste just into your browser. You could paste into a script that knew how to, that can make HTTP calls. You can paste in, or you could just hold on to it and run it again. And this script, this is just a definition of the web service call. There's nothing special about this, and this will work over and over and over again. It's not information from your session or anything else. So you could actually just copy and paste this. Information, and there's your station graph. There's your station file. And there's still a good number. There's a good 464 rows of stream data in Dane County, Wisconsin that samples for nutrient data. And there's a similar for results. So you're pulling off of the result endpoint instead of off of the station endpoint. And the web service, this is a core piece of functionality for future use of the portal. And as you can see, this data, the front end that you see here is just a thin layer on top of the web service. And again, and there's an extensive web service guide that you can, if you're a developer and you're familiar with building web services, interacting with web services or APIs, you can use this to build your own APIs using your own tool. And this service can be considered quite stable. We may eventually deprecate it or release an alternate version, but that will be years from now and with years of warning. So that's a basic rundown of the use of the portal.